I think we are heading in the right direction, I really feel that. And statistically that was backed up, which was nice. Always character before talent, before physicality, before all of that stuff. I think whoever we bring in, it needs to be the right character for the squad, what we need, someone who's going to really buy into, to be brave enough to play the way we want to play first and foremost, but also buy into the group and be part of the group. It's an incredible group of players. We're not going to sign anyone that's really athletic and dynamic, but lacks in character or doesn't have the right character for this group. So character first, the rest will come after. And the biggest trait for us is someone who sees the big picture here and wants to be here. There's absolutely no point in me stressing about, are we going to lose one of our players? I think we're ready for any situation. We have a certain amount of targets in all positions. But yeah, there's just so much to look forward to and be excited about, I think.
Russell, thanks for joining us on Swans TV. You'll be glad to know this is almost certainly your last interview of your first season with Swansea. But now the campaign is over, you know, how do you reflect on it all? Obviously, one with many challenges along the way.
Yeah, it's been... I'm really grateful to everyone and for the support we've had this season from you guys, the backroom staff, the players. So I feel my overwhelming feeling is just really grateful to be here, to have had the season that we've had in terms of the challenge has been, it's been huge. Like so many situations this year that we probably couldn't predict or foresee coming. But I think the way that everyone's dealt with them has been brilliant. And it's been tough, but it's been really rewarding for us to see the amount of growth in certain people, individuals and the collective here in terms of the culture and how much everyone is behind it, which has been incredible for us, really. So, yeah, I just feel really grateful about it. I feel there's like a... When I let my ego kick in and there's a certain bit of frustration and stuff, where there was key moments where if they'd gone our way or if we hadn't have had so much challenge or we're fighting against so much, then we maybe could have had a very different season. But it also excites me a lot for next season because I feel that we are much closer to the team we want to be. We got much closer towards the end of the season to where we wanted to be. So yeah, I'm just really proud of everyone for what they've given us. And want more, for sure. Like not really overly satisfied where we finished in the league, but also I knew there was going to be a hell of a lot of a challenge. And I said along the way, there was going to be quite a bit of pain to get where we want to get to because we are trying to do something that is different. Sometimes change and people seeing different things, it doesn't always, you don't always get the time you need to try and implement that. But fortunately, we've been given real patience and real time and hopefully we'll reward that next season.
Yeah, because there's some strong foundations in place, aren't there? I think if you look at the style of play you want to implement, you know, things like obviously the highest share of possession in the Championship, highest number of passes, so that dominance with the ball. I think our XG and shots on goal constantly improved as the season went on. You know, shots against us, passes against us, you know, all those sort of indicators, if you like, are there, aren't they? They're there to build on.
Yeah, I think so. I think we were always, and we were always keeping tabs on that, because like... The numbers and the data sometimes are not important. Sometimes they really are because they can evidence where you're going to. And we used it quite a lot with the players to sort of show them where we were going and why. And people have to understand the why. And the players really do. It's my job as like the spokesperson of the group really to try and get everyone else to understand why. So the supporters, yourselves, you know, to understand the purpose of what we're trying to do really. And I think you're right. We got a little bit too open in the last five or six games, especially Forest and Bournemouth in terms of chances conceded. But there's a lot of reasons for that. There's a lot of people who are conscious that their season's coming to a close. The summer is uncertain for them. So then that changes the dynamic a little bit, and that's difficult to manage, which is why I really want to be competing for something next season at the end of the season, because all of that doesn't come into the equation if you're really fighting for something. So, I think you're right. Statistically, the guys were improving all the time. The dominance with the ball was there from very early on, which I was really pleased with. But early on, I think people, and maybe sometimes rightly, because we really try and implement something for the players, that the ball is, we need the ball. The ball is ours, especially, you know, to dominate the ball. To try and dominate as far away from our goal as possible is the best form of defence, to move the ball at speed, And early on, it lacked a bit of speed. It probably did lack a bit of purpose. We didn't get enough shots or chances on goal. But I also said to the guys when came in, that's going to be the last bit, because to implement something, we have to build up properly, together, clean, organised, to be able to win it back quickly. And we saw signs of that really early on, which was really, really pleasing and exciting for us. And then it was just at some point, the guys just let go of the fear and the vulnerability. I think moving Nortz to the middle of the back three certainly helped that, because he just plays with so much courage. And they got braver and braver as the season went on. They got more connected with each other, more connected with what we're trying to build. And I think players were just being themselves, which was beautiful and brilliant for us to see as a group of coaching staff. If you look at some of the personalities we've got, how much they were able to express themselves towards the end of the season, which is really exciting for us. And but yeah, I feel like in my second full season as a head coach or a manager, it was a huge amount of learning, because of the amount of challenge we had. And you know, even in my first season, COVID hit and all that, this one's been much more challenging, but much more rewarding as well, because of, as I said, the amount of growth we've seen in certain people and just the club that we're at and how the people have been with us. So yeah, I think we are heading in the right direction. I really feel that. And statistically, that was backed up, which was nice. And now we've just got to make sure we keep improving. I think that's the aim for anyone. And we have a really clear process and plan and way we want to do things. And we just have to keep improving that. And we've sat down as a group of staff at the end of the season and sort of just, you know, like a post-mortem, really. We do pre-mortems throughout the season. What could hurt us? What could be a problem? What could come up? What are we doing well? But to sit down at the end of the season and have that and detailed discussion about where we can improve, there's some really key points and key areas where we feel we definitely can improve on what we do, the process day in, day out. And if we can improve those areas and improve them well, I think it'd make a big difference to us.
Yeah, you know, without giving too much away, can you give us an insight into what some of those areas are?
Well, I think set pieces is a really obvious one for everyone. So if I look at Huddersfield, I think they scored 21 set piece goals and they're in the playoffs. We scored, I think, the third most open play goals in the league. The most with a goalkeeper start with the ball at his feet, which is brilliant. Shows how much work they put in on the training pitch. We spent a fair defensive set pieces. We were pretty good. We were well in the top 10, I think. But the attacking set pieces, only scored two. It can make a big difference in your team. And if you look at Fulham, I think they scored the most set piece goals. So despite them being, you know, playing some great stuff and having Mitch Fish scored a lot of goals from set pieces, they end up scoring a lot of goals from set pieces. So that's, I think, it's a really clear and key area for us. And some of that comes down to personnel. We haven't got the most, you know, the biggest team in terms of presence and height. And so that's something we'll address in terms of personnel, but it's also down to us to, put more focus on them, for the players especially, and do more work. And I think, again, it probably comes down to time and having to prioritise certain things throughout the season. We had to prioritise the performance and getting that right and how the team's going to look and the identity of the team. So that is there. We have the structure, we have the framework for that, the building blocks for that. To add other bits on now is really important, and set pieces are definitely one of them. And there's loads of other little bits that probably not tangible for in terms of data and stats, but for us and day to day how we work, definitely we'll improve.
And you mentioned a few times in recent weeks about your own learning process, as you just did there. Again, could you sum up? It was such an unusual season, but can you sum up what you've learned, Russell, as you're developing?
Yeah, I think I'm really comfortable with the way that we choose to behave culturally as a group of staff or with the players. I don't see warmth or kindness as a weakness, really. So I'm really comfortable with that. I think it was one of the questions I had when coming back to this level. I've been here a lot as a player. How would that work with certain egos? But we don't have any here, really. And that's down to the group of players we have and the staff and the club and the feel around it. It's not that sort of place. So the dynamic of that, the culture, I've been really, really pleased with. For my own learning, I think, it's just making sure that just ego never gets in the way, really. And I think it's so important that the game as a football is a brilliant, beautiful game, but it has a way of, you know, chewing people up and changing people. And I think for me, it's being able to adapt and being able to tweak things without losing without losing what we really believe in, really. So I think this has been a really challenging season for that. And I'm really glad we've come through that as a group to stick to what we believe in. Because I think, you know, I watched an interview recently of Ange Postecoglou, the Celtic manager, has done a brilliant job up there, but saying about the game will challenge your beliefs every single day. And is spot on, really, really spot on. So I think, for me, I've learned so much about what's important, where I can improve on certain bits, what I need to add to my repertoire of skills or whatever you want to call it. And there's lots of improvement to be made and to be had. And but again, I'm just, yeah, I think the biggest thing for me, Andrew, and what I've learned is just to be present. That's it. Like, I can only ever control the moment. If I'm sitting with a player in the office, that's it. If we're on a training pitch, give everything I've got to the group of players I'm working with, to the individual I'm working with. If I'm in a discussion with you, give everything I've got. Be really present. And it's really difficult in football sometimes to do that, because you always have, especially as a head coach, you're talking to someone, you think, I've got to go and talk to someone else in a minute. I've got to do this on the training pitch. There's a game on Saturday to worry about. I need to watch the opposition. But ultimately, all I ever have is the moment we have. We're sitting here talking now about the season. That is it. So the season's gone. Can't affect it. Don't know what's going to happen tomorrow. Don't know what's going to happen after this interview. So it's like real presence and trying to... We've been trying to say that to the players throughout the season. It's like when you're training, just give it everything you've got. That's all you have. Like the last, it could be your last training session. The moment you have with the players, that's it. After that, then... you'll have some time to do it, you know, but wait, be really focused, be really present. And then you do all that Monday to Friday. On the Saturday, you can play in the same way. And people talk about being in the zone, about instinct, about flow state, and it's just presence. So I think that's the biggest thing I've learned this year, is to try and remain present all the time, not to get worried about what's going to come on the Saturday. Be aware, and of course, you do all your work around trying to prepare yourself for that, but to not engage with ego or with the angst and the stress of all that stuff, and just give everything you've got to the people you're working with, and that is it. I don't always get it right, because there is so much to focus on, and there has been so much challenge this year as well, but when you start focusing on stuff that's ultimately not really important, the people are the most important bit, then I think it starts to affect you. So I think presence is, for me, the biggest learning this year, after in everything, not just football, in life really.
I mean, this is probably a bit of an unfair question then, Russell, to follow up on what you've just talked about then, in terms of being in the moment and being present, because I was going to ask you about the transfer window and the summer ahead. I mean, you've talked about, you know, the physical makeup of the squad in terms of things like set pieces there. You've talked a lot about athleticism. Are those the sort of key things you're looking for in anyone that you bring in over the course of the season?
I think the key thing before any of that is character. So always character before talent, before... physicality, before all of that stuff. So I think whoever we bring in, it needs to be the right character for the squad, what we need, someone who's going to really buy into, to be brave enough to play the way we want to play first and foremost, but also buy into the group and be part of the group, because it's an incredible group of players here. Been so surprised by that. I think the skipper leads it, no ego, willing to take on new things all the time, so brave. And then it just filters down, you know, Nort's so brave, Pato so brave, albeit in his mad, maverick way. But yeah, just Michael with his energy and all that, you know, and then you've got young lads like Ben Cabango, Flynn Downs, just really finding themselves and making their way. So people have to come and fit into the group, first and foremost, character-wise. And then, of course, after that, you look at the stuff. So we're not going to sign anyone that's really athletic and dynamic, but lacks in... character or doesn't have the right character for this group. So character first, the rest will come after. And the biggest trait for us is someone who sees the big picture here and wants to be here, and then is brave enough to play the way that we want to play. So either has not built up a huge amount of fear yet in their career and can express themselves and be themselves, or he wants to overcome and embrace the fear and overcome it and actually start showing what they're capable of. So, yeah, I'm really excited about that. I think again, it's about, we just spoke about the present stuff. There's absolutely no point in me stressing about, are we going to lose one of our players? It's just being ready. Just being ready for whatever happens. And I think we are. I think we're ready for any situation. We have a certain amount of targets in all positions. There'll be one, if we have some money to spend all of a sudden, there'll be one who doesn't cost any money. There'll be one loan player there. So, and that's been like just constant working from January onwards, and with the recruitment team and with us as a group of coaching staff, sitting in watching players, having a look statistically who matches, and then finding out about character. So all of that work's still going on. More than ever, like, people keep saying to me, are you enjoying a break? I'm not really on a break. It's just doing all the stuff that a head coach or manager does without the fun stuff on the grass for 2 hours or in the video room. So it's all the other stuff, just the phone calls constantly. So yeah, I think we're really clear what we want. I don't know if we'll get all of what we want. I don't know if we'll get some of it. I don't know if we'll get any of it. But yeah, we can just be ready, and clear on what and why we need certain things. And yeah, I'm sure that will all come to light over the next 6, 7, 8 weeks or whatever. We'll know we're back in pre-season already in 4 or 5 weeks. So yeah, I just think, again, there's so much noise around the transfer window. It's just up to us to focus on what we actually want and what we're doing.
Yeah, because that contingency planning is so important, Russell, isn't it? I mean, I think you've touched on it before. You know, if you're not in the top half a dozen teams in the Premier League, you have to have that contingency plan, don't you? Because an ideal window probably doesn't maybe exist for a
championship. No, of course. Yeah, I think I just think we want to try and avoid doing something at the last minute because we feel we have to do it. So it's just just trying to be as prepared as possible. I think transfer windows are tough for every club, every team. You never get 100% of what you want. They're fluid, they change all the time in terms of personnel, availability. I was just trying to find some enjoyment in that as well. That it's not very enjoyable, the phone calls and stuff, but just trying to find, actually, at the end of it, we'll end up with a really good player, a character that's right for us. Otherwise, just won't do it. So, I think we're just all excited to see the changes we can make. I don't think the squad needs, in terms of, if you look at, I think we used the least players last year. There was an issue with our squad depth, if you like. But the core group of players that's played a lot, they've been brilliant. And we just need to add around them and add a little bit more depth. And I think really exciting.
We'll just finish off the look ahead to pre-season, Russell. Obviously going to be very important for you. I think you've touched on it a number of times, having not had one last year. You know, how much are you looking forward to that? And I'd imagine you're a long way down the line with the planning. And
Yes, pretty much. Yeah, planned and excited for that. The games obviously the fixtures are sort of being finalised now, in terms of just waiting for the other clubs to confirm it. And so, yeah, I think really excited to have pre-season with the group. It's such an important time to really implement some things tactically. But most importantly, like, how we're going to behave together, how we're going to work, you know, psychologically, for the team to work out what's important to them, for the players to work out what's really important to them for this season, what they want to stand for, what they want to be known for. All of that, really, really excited. And I think to just condition the players to play in our way, in the Swansea way, condition them from day one, rather than coming in and, as I said to you, like, building a plane in flight last season. So really looking forward to that and really excited about it. I think the players are as well. I think they really are. So we'll have 6 weeks of really hard work, intense work. Hopefully it'll be a lot of fun as well. And hopefully you guys will be there to film a lot of it and show people the journey from day one. And there's just so much to look forward to and be excited about, I think. And you can choose to focus on that, or you can choose to focus on the other stuff that would frustrate the life out of you. But yeah, full pre-season really excites us. And I think we'll just be in such a good place for the start of next season, really. So it is planned. There'll be some tweaks and changes to it, of course. The players have been given a brilliant off-season programme by Matty Wilmot and the gang, and really top draw. And I think they've looked at that, and I think they realise, the players as well, that they need to come back ready. I think pre-season's or the off-season's changed a lot from what it was. You know, tend to switch off for a couple of weeks, and that's so important. The players do switch off and eat what they want and do what they want for a week or two, and then it's time to, you know, enjoy a break, but get ready to come in and, and condition yourself ready for pre-season so you can hit the ground running. So I'm pretty confident we've got a group of players who will do that. They're really professional, really diligent, and just good men, really, good young men. So, yeah, really excited to get to work, and hopefully we'll show the benefit of that.
Yeah, well, I'm sure all supporters looking forward to it as well, Russell. So thanks very much for your time again.
No worries.